What's crack-a-lack and Nipher? It's Hadley.
And Addison. Meow!
Today's National Black Cat Day.
Spooky! Did you know black cats are known as bad luck because they're connected to witches?
And they were thought to capture souls and be shapeshifters.
Whoa, mega spooky.
Anyways, let's honor our flag for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Congratulations to all the students who ran in the first annual Nipher vs. North cross-country race on Wednesday, October 19th. Here are the top finalists.
Wow, cross-country requires a lot of exercise.
Just like racquetball.
We have a racquetball team at Nipher that is causing quite the racket.
Haha, that's a good one.
Let's go learn more about racquetball with Bill and Cal.
The racquetball season is about to start, and the defending state champions are ready to step onto the court and smash some balls. The Kirkwood Middle School racquetball team ranges from 6th graders to 8th graders and is a combined Nipher and North team. The team consists of 60 student athletes, making it the largest middle school program in the country.
Matches start tomorrow and go until mid-February, ending with the state championship, which Kirkwood has had a lot of success. Our girls' middle school team has won state back-to-back seasons. Meanwhile, the boys' middle school team has won the state title 3 years in a row.
Last year, the 8th graders came through and played well in state to win the tournament. But this year is a different story. The team has a lot of new players, and they will have to come through to deliver the title to Kirkwood.
How are you guys liking racquetball so far?
Good.
I like it a lot.
And what are you guys looking forward to?
The very first game.
Playing a lot of games and winning.
Kirkwood will be led by freak athlete and absolute specimen Bennett Crussell. Bennett Crussell is Kirkwood's top returning boy and one of the top middle school players in Missouri.
What's it going to take to repeat as state champions?
We have quite a few good players on the team and a lot of players in general, so I think we should be able to win state this year.
And on a personal level, what's it going to take to achieve all your goals?
I'm going to need to work hard at practices and maybe put in some extra time out of practices and games.
On the girls' side, they are looking to make it a three-peat, so let's go interview some girls that will be stepping into the spotlight. One goal you have for the upcoming racquetball season?
To win some matches.
Win a match.
And what's your favorite part about playing racquetball?
Just like going to the practices and having fun.
Like seeing my friends.
Thank you.
Wow, I just love hearing about sports.
And you can't have sports without really good coaches.
We have some teachers who double as coaches here at Nipher.
Yeah, let's go to Charlie and Keegan for more about Nipher coaches.
They train you, they teach you, and they'll always be there for you when it comes to sports.
Can you guess who they are?
Coaches.
When it comes to sports coaches, their main goal is to try and get you to be the best athlete you can while teaching you valuable life lessons and skills.
They want to see you go far in sports, but also see you grow as a human being.
Friday, October 6th was National Coaches Day.
Let's take a look at some of the most popular coaches around the college and professional sports world.
Johnny B. Dusty Baker Jr. is an American baseball manager and former player who is the manager of the Houston Astros in Major League Baseball. He previously played in MLB for 19 seasons, and he's most known for his career with the Los Angeles Dodgers.
William Scott Bowman, OC, is a Canadian former National Hockey League head coach. He holds the record for the most wins in league history with 1,244 wins in the regular season and 223 in the Stanley Cup playoffs, thus ranking second of all time for most Stanley Cup victories by player, coach, or executive with 14.
Now, let's look at Nipher's very own coaches.
Mr. Dixon.
And what sports do you coach?
Outside of Nipher, soccer, but at Nipher, basketball.
How long have you been coaching?
This will be my second year coaching basketball, and I've coached soccer for like 3 years.
What's your favorite part about coaching?
Watching the players develop into great athletes.
All right, thank you.
What sports do you coach?
You know, I coach JV baseball. I'm assistant coach on the JV baseball team for Kirkwood, and also coach the 8th grade basketball team here at Nipher.
How long have you been coaching?
Let's see. I've been coaching just for about 7 or 8 years.
Mm-hmm.
What's your favorite part about coaching?
You know, it's gotta be the kids. It's gotta be the ball players. We just have a lot of fun. You get more, you spend more time with them and influence them more, and just see them grow and develop is a lot of fun.
Thank you.
I'm Miss Rachel.
And how long have you been coaching?
This will be my third year as the Nipher coach, and I coached my niece one time in a church league.
What's your favorite part about coaching?
I just love getting to spend time with the kids. It's totally different than an academic environment, and I just love seeing them work hard and get to be a team with one another.
What would you say is your best coaching accomplishment?
Well, last year we had a winning record. I don't even think we lost a game, so that was really awesome because, I mean, they had to build that together, and so it was just a lot of fun to watch.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Wow, I really got to know those Nipher coaches.
Yeah, I wonder if we can know more about our Nipher principals.
Well, you're in luck. Martha has a segment on our Nipher principals.
The month of October is National Principals Month, so let's find out some more interesting facts about our beloved principals.
Our principals are
Dr. Dickinson in 6th grade, Mr. Alwood in 7th grade, and Dr. Havener in 8th grade. Let's go find out some more about their jobs.
Our final principal, Mr. Alwood, grew up in St. Louis. He went to high school at Clore North High School. He went to college in many places, including Community College, Unzel, and Lindenwood. He has 3 kids, and in his free time, he likes to play pickleball and go outside.
If you weren't a principal, what would you want to be?
A teacher.
What's your favorite part of being a principal?
Working with teachers and students and seeing the success from both of them, obviously the success from students when sometimes things are a challenge.
And what made you want to be a principal?
I was an interventionist 1 year, and I worked with a lot of different teachers, and I really like to be in different teachers' classrooms, see what they're doing, and it's always impressive to see how much hard work and the heart they put in to their subject content area and the students, and I enjoy it, so I learned to be doing that more.
Great, thank you.
Mr. Alwood kind of looks like Jimmy Fallon, don't you think?
Yeah, 100%. And guess what's on today?
Celebrity lookalikes! Wait, with who?
With us, you goofy goober.
Well, then what are we waiting for?
Who would have thought that a girl like me would double as a superstar?
Well, that's all for today, Nipher. Thanks for tuning in.
It's been Hadley.
And Addison.
Don't forget to like.
And subscribe.
And remember, you belong in Nipher!